Your Excellency, Commissioners. I want to begin by making a very brief comment about my sense of the Constitution. Again, I think it's a great effort, but I'm sorry, I think it suffers from a little bit of schizophrenia. And I think we have an opportunity to try and cure it. I say this because in many portions of the Constitution, which unfortunately I only just read overnight, you find that it's at loggerheads with itself. The first part is, it acknowledges that the purpose of government is to seek the well-being, the welfare of Ghanaians. And yet, the many Ghanaians that were born in Ghana that are naturally to be expected to be of concern to it are deliberately excluded from its concern. In fact, deliberately gone after. My learned friend just referred to one of the provisions here, which is quite interesting, where a child is born of a parent or grandparent on or after the coming into effect of the Constitution, outside Canada, outside Ghana, that person becomes automatically a citizen. And yet, that parent, who may have been born in Ghana, is deliberately gone after and stripped if he acquires citizenship elsewhere. Now, this is critical because it is the case that most people, almost all everybody here, who the Commission sees as Ghanaians, I've said this before our Honourable Excellency, are actually technically not Ghanaian. And the part of the schizophrenia is that naturally Ghana feels the need to come and speak to these people, but these people he has rejected.
That's right.
So there is a real serious problem with the Constitution. So I say the one key thing, okay, sorry?
Straight to your point.
Straight to the point? Okay, so one point is that the preamble to the Constitution needs to be beefed up to stress the commitment of the Constitution to ensure that government and all institutions of the state seek the well-being of Ghanaians everywhere. That's the first one. And then the second part is that there needs to be two categories identified and embraced, actually, in the Constitution. One explicit category, you might call it, born Ghanaians with foreign citizenship. And the other category you might call Ghanaians with sole, persons with sole Ghanaian citizenship. And the first category are specifically to be identified outside of all persons who might acquire citizenship of Ghana as a particular population because of birth, whose citizenship will be in fact deliberately sought, not repudiated by constitution or by practice. In fact, everything goes contrary otherwise. And the last point, okay. There are many issues to be raised, but maybe a question can be
answered. No, Mr. Michael, if your submission is written,
yes,
you can give in your submission,
sure,
and the Commission will be glad to consider your submission.
I will definitely do that. I just thought I might engage.
Okay. Thank you. Don't leave yet till share the chat as well.
Michael, schizophrenia.
Very strong, sorry.
And loggerheads. That's very combative.
Yes, I'm so sorry, actually.
I just want to take the opportunity to say that in putting together an architecture of a constitution, you're balancing a number of policy situations.
Yes.
And we don't consider that, as public lawyers, we don't consider that to be the constitution at loggerheads with itself. These are deliberate choices that countries make based on various policies. So I take your submission to be saying that the policy that classifies a number of Ghanaians as non-Ghanaians should be addressed. That's fundamentally your submission.
Yes, but more than that, if I can. I think
you have a written paper for us.
I will, yes. I have a clean it up a little bit more, and I'm submitting.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, you may just complete your thought.
Okay. I think as a matter of public policy, the Constitution should actually set out deliberately, actually, to embrace. In fact, for many reasons, one, and I make this very briefly, that for one of the former ambassadors living here in the Senate party, and I was very impressed with his comment and caution, and he said to all of us, one of the things that he was going to take back to Ghana was the recognition of a risk that was attendant to Ghana that we're walking blindly into without recognizing to address proactively. And that is the danger that as Ghanaians grow and pass on, those who are outside here, their children are less and less likely to be inclined to identify with Ghana. And yet, a huge component of the income of the country, directly or indirectly, derives from remittances from this part of the world. And the moment that bond is severed, Ghana truly is at risk. So it's a crucial matter in itself. There are many issues to be raised. I wouldn't bother to detain you.
Thank you very much. That's Michael. On that note, you may step down. On that note, Council, I'm going to pass on the chair to Commissioner Ponsan whilst I slip out to attend to some very urgent matter. So,